Hey there guys, how's everybody doing? It's me, the Brave Hylian, back bringing you more Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, Oracle of Ages. And in the last episode, we started the Wing Dungeon. Here we are back in there again, and let's see if we can't try and get some more done. And like I said last time, we started the dungeon, and we got to the mini-boss, and he just totally kicked my ass. So, this time, let's see if we can't turn the tables on and bring his miserable life to an end. Alright, and man, you can't push it that way, I guess, or I'm just being weak, or... Dude, well come on, push the block. Can I not push it for some reason, or do I have to defeat all the snakes or something, or... Well, wow, I'm just baffled right now. This is just kind of weird. Well, I moved it that time, maybe you did have to beat all the snakes, that was odd. Well, anyway, let's see if we can't make our way back to that boss, because we owe him a knuckle sandwich, don't we? And, man, we are just not going to be able to deliver it to him without any hearts, so I'm going to see if I can get some here, and there's one, that's good. Let's see if we can get some of those bats down here and get some hearts back, because I'll tell you what, I got a pretty long way with half a heart, but he just really kind of gave me a run for my money, so let's see if I can't get this bat over here to give me a heart. And hopefully I don't lose one in the process of trying to get him, and I didn't there, and then let's see if we can get this guy. Nope, he didn't give me a heart, so what we're going to have to do with what we got, which is 2.5, so that should be alright. And we take the minecart again, the Donkey Kong Country minecart, and we go over to the boss room and try and get him again. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Hopefully this guy will give us the jumping item, the feather or whatever, when we're done with him, so... One with no wings is no match for me. Yeah, don't be a prick, dude. Come on. We all know you're gonna dive bomb me, and then I'm gonna hit you with my sword, and then it'll be over. Shoot. Alright, I can only hit him once there. But he got kind of violent with me last time after I hit him a couple times. He jumped on me and jumped on me and just kept jumping on me or something. Oh, when I got hit again there, I need to stop doing that. So basically, I can only get hit by him 4 more times. Try to make that 0. 0 more times. Don't get hit by him again. Alright, come on, man. I don't know what... Come on, there we go. Got him once more. I just can't even figure out what this guy is supposed to be. He's just like a little winged dude. I called him Pidgeot last time, but... Now that I look at him, he's not really a Pidgeot. He's just a bear with winged ears or something. I don't know. He's just being... I don't know if I'm just being weird or... I don't know. He looks pretty weird to me. And he hit me again. And if I had lose to this guy again, there will be hell to pay. Because I lost a lot of health being stupid when I was trying to get over here to fight him. And now, I just can't seem to get my shit together, so we'll see what we can do. I need to back away. I'm trying to get too close to try and get like a couple hits on him, but it's not gonna work. Oh, shoot. Well, okay, well he bounced twice that time, so now I know what I'm looking for at least. Once, twice, hit him. Oh, he did it 3 times that time! What the hell, man? And then I didn't even have time to recover before this thing hit me. That's not fair at all. Jeez, man. Not cool. Totally not cool. I need some hearts or like a fairy. These pots have been being really stingy about giving me a fairy. Or a heart or anything. Man. Well... Oh, shoot, that's not what I meant to do. I meant to get my shield out so I can kill these guys. Maybe they'll give me a heart and try not to get killed myself, hopefully. Oh, there's one. No, but this guy hit me. What a jerk. Oh, now I've lost more than I had. Man, maybe those snakes will give me some, though. Because I have got to get more than I have before I start this guy again. Because, obviously, whatever I had last time just was not enough. Maybe it's because I'm out of practice playing Zelda games, or maybe it's because... Nah, I just couldn't tell you. I'm just doing really bad. Maybe it's just that I've never played this game before, and I don't really know what to expect or how to beat this guy. Because usually once I face a mini-boss a couple of times, I have a good strategy for beating him. And man, if the mini-boss just killed me twice, I can only imagine what the actual boss of this dungeon is going to do to me, so... I don't even want to think about what that was, but... Last time in the first dungeon, the boss wasn't that hard. I just didn't know what to do in the beginning, and then... The mini-boss, he seemed to give me a lot of trouble, even though I didn't die against him, but we'll just have to see how that goes. Alright, let's see if we can get this guy once more. You know, like, once more into the breach, dear friends, once more. Okay, you little jerk. One with no wings. Don't say that to me. Don't even go there, because I am a match for you. Even though you've embarrassed me up till this point. People watching this video probably think I'm really lame for losing to you again. Maybe they will have forgotten that I lost to him last time. Oops, I just said that. Oh, don't... Oh, man, I totally just ran into him. Like, he didn't even land on me. I just ran into him as soon as he came down, like a doofus. I don't know why I can't seem to get this guy. He doesn't stay on the ground for a very long time, so you gotta be really careful. You gotta be really precise when you fight this guy. That's what I've learned so far. You gotta back up and then turn around and hit him and then run away, because he's gonna... You're either gonna run into him, or he's gonna get up and just fly away, and you're not gonna be able to hit him anymore. Okay, so there comes a point where he starts getting really angry, and he'll bounce multiple times. So, I don't know if I've hit it yet, but... He starts going a little bit faster, I think. So, yeah, I think this is it. So, we'll see if we can't get him this time. One, two, three. Oh. Alright, well, he took a half a heart, but I hit him a couple times, so... got him. Alright, well, he's taking away some health, but... We're getting some damage, so we'll see if we can't... There we go, that's what I'm talking about. See, I knew he could not last me for too long. Oh, man. Right, that is a relief right there. I'm really glad I beat him that time. Whew, hopefully those holes in the floor start disappearing. So that we can... Or so that I can get to that warp point, because that'd be a bummer. I'm gonna go down here. Oh, jeez, man. All these Stalfoses shoot me with arrows. I am looking for the item that I'm getting in this dungeon, because from the way I've seen, it looks like it's going to be way easier to get around when I get that item. And I'm just guessing that it's the feather, because there's been lots of stuff, like little holes in the ground and everything, that it seems like you would need that for. So, I think that's what it is. Let's see what this guy says. Let's see if he's any more helpful than all the other owls have been. With the blue wing, soar over the colored heights. Well, you know, I would. I don't really have the blue wing, so I'm not really sure if I should have already gotten it, or if I'm just being stupid. Oh, man, don't... Now, don't beat the mini-boss and then just die in another part of the dungeon, because that would just be silly. Oh, that's what we're looking for. Got the rock's feather. Feel light as a feather. I knew it was the rock's feather. So I kind of like how these areas where you get the items are, like, like in Zelda. They kind of remind me of Zelda 2 a little bit. Because it's 2D, and... Oh, what's up there? Is that a gacha seed? No, it's a ruby. Oh, I don't care about that. Yeah, like I said, it reminds me of Zelda 2, so... Brings back some pretty good memories of that game. So I was supposed to leap and hit the colored heights, except I pressed the wrong button, and I swung my sword instead of jumping. Oh, shoot. Oh, fell in the hole on accident. That was dumb. Oh, shoot. I guess I'm not supposed to jump on there? What is it? Oh, here I am, reading what he said again. Oops, that's not what I meant to do. Want to continue? Okay, good. Alright. Let's get some mystery seeds. And he said, with the blue wing, soar over the colored heights. Soar over the colored heights. Maybe this is not what he's talking about. But I can't seem to get out of this room, so I guess we'll just have to soar to the colored heights. I don't know. And I swear I pressed the button that time. I swear I did. I promise I did. Alright, it says soar to the colored heights, but I'm soaring... And the colored height, I'm not getting there, so... Okay, well, I'm here, right? So, I'm trying to jump on there, and it's not working, and I tried to push the block, and it didn't work. Let's go down here and see if we can get some life from these bats or something. Because I really, if there's anything I hate, it's walking around a dungeon with one heart left, just waiting to get hit by an enemy and get killed. Nope. Yeah, didn't give me that time, did you? Just couldn't do it. Am I supposed to maybe get up there somehow? Well, there's a heart. I'm glad to see that. Like, get over here, bat. Why are your patterns so much more erratic than they were? Oh, well. I guess nothing doing there, but, with the blue feather, soar to the colored heights. So, here I am on this yellow platform. And I just can't seem to get to the colored height from here. And I tried pushing it, and it didn't work, and then... maybe I have to hit it with my sword or something, but... Man, oh, I swear, falling in these holes is getting so old, man. I'll tell you what, and oh, jeez, now I'm just losing all the coordination that I ever did have. Well, I don't know what to tell you. I'm on the colored thing, and I'm jumping, and I just don't know what to do. Maybe is there another item that I can maybe... The harp wouldn't help. The bomb probably wouldn't help. Lighting it on fire doesn't seem like it would help. I don't know what the shield would really do. Let me see what this guy says again and see if I can decode what he's trying to tell me. Let's see. With the blue wing, soar over the colored heights. Okay. I can't really soar. I mean, I can jump. I don't want to say that I'm soaring, really. I'm gonna try and grind for some life from the bats here, and that's not gonna work this time. Ugh. Read this one more time, maybe it'll give me a dose of inspiration. With the blue wing, soar over the colored heights. Soar over the colored heights. Well, I can't get over this colored height, so I don't know what they're really, what it's really talking about. Maybe I have to jump over the yellow thing, and that will somehow allow me to jump over the blue one. Oh, wait. Okay, I have to jump over that block to change the color of it. Okay, that makes way more sense. Okay, well, at least I figured it out now. I'm glad I did that. And if I die here, I'm gonna be really, really embarrassed. Oh, man, if I try to press the button and it doesn't work one more time. Oh, yes. Okay, good. I feel way better now about it. Let's see where this railroad's gonna take us. And, oh, shoot. Jump. How do I get out of here? Oh, I can't. Get out of... Oh, I want to jump out, but I can't, so it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to... Oh, shoot. Well, is there, like, a switch? Can I hit this switch? Yes, I can. Okay, good. Because it's not going to let me go there, so I want to get out here and see what I can find. It looks like there's a bombable wall over here, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. Oh, shoot. I keep forgetting that you automatically pick it up whenever you lay a bomb. It's really confusing me. All right, well, we made the key noise, so that's going to be... I'm gonna look for a key in here, probably kill all the enemies. All the Stalfoses with their swords. The sworded Stalfos. Oh, and I hate when you have to kill bats to get a key or whatever. So annoying. Alright, let's see what this chest has to offer us. A small key. Won't complain. Oh man, this dungeon's been giving me a little more trouble than the last one did, let me tell you that right now. Alright, so I guess I wanna... Do I wanna push this on the red? Nope. I don't know what color this is supposed to be. Like, oh, it's yellow because the thing is yellow, so I'm guessing that's what it's trying to get me to do. Yellow? Okay, I don't know how these blocks are... They're pretty tricky, I'm not gonna lie. Nope, not gonna be that. Can I fall in this hole? No, I can't. Okay, good. See if we can get a yellow on there. Yellow, yeah, here we go. No, you don't want yellow either? Well, then I guess you want blue. I mean, I can give you blue. Don't get me wrong. I can give you blue. There we go. Okay, I guess that's what we want. So now let's get back in the minecart and see where it takes us. Man. This dungeon's starting to stress me out a little bit, guys. I'm not going to lie. I'm getting a little crazy in here. Alright, so now we got a bunch of different colored blocks. So how I did that was I jumped over the heights, right? And I made them... Oh, I'm guessing I have to make this pattern right here is what they want me to do. Okay, so now I just have to jump on that one. There we go. And we get a key to fall from the sky, and the P-hats are going to attack me. But anyway, I'm going to go in this corner and rest for a minute. And that is going to be all for this episode of Let's Play Legend of Zelda Oracle of Ages. Thank you for joining me on this epic journey. This is the Brave Hylian, signing off for now. See you next time.